We now know that speech has to be heard and understood, that the amount of background noise in the classroom affects learning, that students furthest away from the teacher are at risk of missing information, and that rate of speech can impact student learning. There is actually a single tool that can have a positive impact on all of these aspects of classroom listening, the Classroom Audio Distribution System, or CADS. You are very likely already familiar with this piece of technology, formerly referred to as a sound field FM system. A CADS is a critical piece of technology for the 21st century classroom. The reality of classroom in today's age includes not only listening to the teacher, but to a litany of other audio sources, such as YouTube videos for current events, podcasts of lectures, movie clips, interactive smartboard activities, and so on. Having good auditory access to all of these auditory sources is critical. Let's start with the most important auditory source, the teacher. Many teachers will say that they do not require a microphone, that they use their teacher voice. However, using a teacher voice may actually be impairing students' access to the speech signal. Remember, by increasing our speech volume, we are only really emphasizing the vowel sounds. This increase in vowel volume can actually cover up or mask the important consonant sounds that carry speech understanding. Now recall the words thin, fin, and sin. To understand the difference between these words, we need to have good access to the initial consonant sounds th, th, and s. So using a teacher voice, go ahead and yell a silent TH sound. I'll do it with you. Not very effective, is it? Now imagine trying to hear those sound distinctions while sitting in the back row of a classroom in the winter. The heating system is on, your ears are stuffed up due to a cold, and your elbow partner just washed down a bag of jelly beans with a Coca-Cola. How are you going to be able to hear those quiet, low energy sounds? You've got it, through the teacher's use of a classroom audio distribution system. When a teacher makes proper use and consistent use of a CADS, not only do all students experience increased speech recognition, but research has repeatedly demonstrated improvements in listening, attention, academic performance, and on-task behaviors. In fact, CADS is one of the most researched positive outcome teaching tools that teachers have access to. When used properly and consistently, CADS improves access to the soft, critical consonant sounds by bringing the teacher's voice above the background noise and by eliminating the issue of a back row. With the use of a CADS, every student has a front row auditory experience. Please keep in mind that CADS are not amplifiers. Rather, they are distribution systems with the intent to distribute your voice evenly throughout the classroom. I would be remiss if I did not mention the fact that CADS also plays a significant role in reducing vocal strain and related sick leave. Teachers are 32 times more likely than any other profession to have voice disorders, and half of all teachers experience a voice disorder at some time in their career, compared to about 5% of the general population. When used consistently, the use of CADS has been shown to reduce teacher absences due to vocal strain and voice fatigue. Not only does the use of a CADS preserve speech clarity and reduce vocal strain, it also allows the teacher to use the full range of their voice through emphasis and expression. This makes for a more interesting and engaging communication style. Please listen to the following example of a teacher teaching with a CADS and then without.
Robert Schumann was born in the small German city of Zwickau in 1810. Beethoven was in his prime, and interestingly, three great composers of the Romantic era, Chopin, Mendelssohn, and Liszt, were all born within a year of Schumann. Robert Schumann was born in the small German city of Zwickau in 1810. Beethoven was in his prime, and interestingly, three great composers of the Romantic era, Chopin, Mendelssohn, and Liszt, were all born within a year of Schumann.
So you've heard how classroom audio distribution systems are amazing teaching tools. However, classroom technology is only as good as its user. That is to say, if used or installed incorrectly, benefits may not be fully achieved. There are three critical items I would like to emphasize with regard to your CADS use. 1. Consistent use. Using the CADS when reading stories or for a long lecture is great. However, long periods of speech are not the only applications for CADS use. CADS are most effective when used consistently and throughout the school day. That is to say, any time that you are addressing your class, even if saying, "Okay, class, books away," using the CADS will ensure that all of your students are getting equal access to the instruction. 2. Microphone volume. The general rule of thumb is that if you can easily hear yourself, the volume is set too loud. Remember, the goal in using CADS is not to amplify your voice, but rather distribute it evenly throughout the classroom so that all students have clear and equal access to your voice. 3. Microphone placement. Correct placement of the microphone is critical for proper transmission of the speech signal. Too often, our microphones worn incorrectly, potentially giving way to other related issues. To be sure of optimal placement, I encourage you to refer to your manufacturer user guide. Some general recommendations are as follows. If your CADS uses a boom microphone, please be sure to wear the microphone in the intended position, around your head. Wearing the mic around your neck is inappropriate, as the microphone is not designed to pick up sound on a vertical plane. Also, be sure that the mic is placed at an appropriate distance from your mouth. If it is too close, popping of the plosive sounds will occur. If your CADS uses a necklace-style microphone, be sure to wear the microphone at the sternum level. Wearing the microphone lower than this will degrade the quality of sound and will likely cause feedback due to the need for higher volume levels. If your CADS uses a clip-on lapel microphone, be sure to clip it at the sternum level and as medially as possible. Again, wearing the microphone lower than this will degrade the quality of sound and will likely cause feedback due to the need for higher volume levels. Please ensure that the microphones are at no times covered by clothing such as scarves or collars, and that jewelry or lanyards are not rubbing against them.